Hello everybody, my name is Wolfgang Miesbach from the University Hospital in Frankfurt, and it's my pleasure to present a short overview about a presentation which I had the opportunity to hold during the annual virtual congress of the European Society of Gene and Cell Therapy. And the title of this talk was Current Update of Clinical Trials on Gene Therapy of Hemophilia. Now, because this congress is focused on very important preclinical and also clinical scientific findings in the general field of gene therapy, I started the presentation with a short overview about hemophilia A and hemophilia B and what it means for a patient to suffer from severe hemophilia. The overview of this talk consisted about recent data of gene therapy trials on hemophilia A and hemophilia B presented at the recent ISDH Congress in July this year, and then to discuss some benefits and also challenges of AAV-based gene transfer in hemophilia, and to close with a model of delivery of gene therapy. Now, this presentation started with the very important 5-year data of the BMN 270201 study using AAV5 isotype. And in this study, there were the 5-year data for the both highest dose cohorts presented using both the chromogenic and the one-stage assay, and also an overview about the bleeding rate and the bleed consumption was given. So even after 5 years, there was a 95% reduction from baseline regarding bleeding rate and a 96% reduction from baseline regarding consumption. And this was followed by the phase 3 study BMN 270301, showing that there was a factor 8 activity over 52 weeks. Another study, SPK-8011, showed up to 4-year data for 4 dose cohorts in hemophilia A. And the next chapter presented some recently published data about gene therapy in hemophilia B, starting with the 5-year data of the AMT-060 study demonstrating sustained dose-dependent increases in factor 9 activity with a factor 9 activity of 5.2% in cohort 1 and 7.4% in cohort 2, even after 5 years, showing sustained reduction in bleeding and factor 9 use. And this was followed by the phase 3 study AMT-061. And this is very interesting because in this study, patients with the detection of pre-existing anti-AAV antibodies were not excluded, but were included, and was interesting to see the outcome of this study. Finally, this presentation focused on safety aspects of gene therapy of hemophilia, starting with early transient hepatotoxicity, which is the main adverse event of AAV-based gene therapy. And some hypotheses about the ALT elevation have been mentioned as well, different treatment concepts. And in addition to that, some liver biopsy data were presented, as well as long-term effects of gene therapy in 2 canine hemophilia models. This was followed by the presentation of some similarities of hemophilia A and hemophilia B gene therapy transfers, as well as differences between these both gene therapy approaches and differences of factor 8 and factor 9. And the presentation closed with a presentation of a hub and spoke model, and also the challenges of gene therapy for hemophilia centers. Some criteria have been defined for the hub center and the spoke center and the interaction between these both centers with the aim that hemophilia centers would be better qualified in gene therapy accessible to all patients irrespective of their country or centre of origin. And this is a summary slide about the current clinical trial experience. We now have persistent expression of factor levels for more than 5 years in both hemophilia A and hemophilia B gene therapy trials. However, the characteristics and outcome may differ between hemophilia A and hemophilia B. Some possible reasons have been mentioned. The presentation focused on possible adverse effects of gene therapy. And finally, a modifiable networked hub-and-spoke model of gene therapy was introduced, which could ensure a safe and efficient delivery of gene therapy in the future. Thank you very much for your attention.